Okay, guys, so according to the International Union for the Conservation of Nature, nearly half the world's entire ape population is at risk for extinction. And the culprit behind this is the activity known as bushmeat. Now, bushmeat is illegal meat prized in Africa, Asia, and Latin America. It's often associated with the hunting of rare ape species. This commercial, unsustainable, and illegal poaching has caused widespread extinction in these countries. Now, this idea came to light when I attended several animal conservation centers in LA, like the Gibbons Center. I've also had several anthropology classes that have profoundly covered this topic that I'll be discussing today. Now, it's morally clear that not many of us would object to the conservation of these beautiful exotic creatures, and in most audiences it can be pretty one-sided that many of us here do worry about the planet we live on. The remnants of ecosystems, endangerment to a plethora of species, and spread of life-threatening diseases proves bushmeat isn't worth it. Clearly, bushmeat industry is inflicting more harm in this world in order for a simple meal for some people. Today, I'd like to alert you guys to the harmful effects of bushmeat. To kick off this sensitive topic, there's one primary reason why bushmeat happens in these countries. And that primary reason is for household consumption for local nourishment. And that's where this guy comes in. Usually, to profit from this meat, poachers use illegal guns and snare traps on silverback gorillas, one of the more popular animals in the bushmeat market. Many who survive the attacks are often left missing limbs, however, like most of the time a trap would amputate a foot or a leg of a silverback gorilla. It can also leave the apes emotionally traumatized. Not too long ago, there was an incident here in California that verified the long-term effects that bushmeat causes to these animals. Michael the gorilla was an orphaned ape who resides in a conservation center at Woodside, California, north of here. He was able to perform sign language taught to him by staff from Stanford University. And at 27 years old, he was able to describe the attacks of his mother from poachers and when he was a baby. And many animals, like Michael, fall victim to poachers and from local villagers as well. Since the ability to raise domestic animals in Central Africa is both limited and costly, bushmeat is their major dependence for protein consumption. Statistically speaking, the average consumption of around 750 households in the region of Gabon near the rainforest, they consume about 3.9 kilograms a month per house. So this means every month, 6,650 pounds of exotic animals are poached and eaten. Now, to clarify, these villagers, they're not necessarily evil people. They're not bad guys. They're very informed of the crisis that's going on and are ethically ashamed as much as us that they must resort to hunting endangered species for the sanctity of their lives and for their families as well. Now, the consequence of bushmeat goes hand in hand with contracting diseases from eating this uncured meat. Another factor that humans face in the bushmeat market is the spreading of zoonotic diseases. Zoonotic diseases are defined as any disease that can be passed on from animals to human beings. And contact, the blood and body fluids from these animals during hunting and butchering is a well-known route of transmission. Of these many diseases, the most notable one would be AIDS. Bushmeat highly contributes to AIDS, which has spread throughout most of the world, with already 40 million people already infected. AIDS is the final stage of its two lentiviruses, HIV-1 and HIV-2. And just so you know, those both happen to have zoonotic disease origins, so they did come from apes and monkeys, from bushmeat. Victimized orphan apes of the bushmeat trade are often sold as pets, primarily in Asia. These young creatures aren't really ideal for trade. because of the lack of meat they provide, their tiny little bodies can't really sustain much. The two most popular apes are gorillas and chimpanzees. And in fact, the most common ape that harbors a virus is in fact the chimpanzee. In the end, these babies that are shipped to other countries only excel at the spreading of HIV, and more recently and notably, Ebola. So, to make matters worse, commercial logging and deforestation has elevated this into a crisis, allowing poachers easier access to animal habitats, which even species not at risk are in danger. Unfortunately, in many areas, bushmeat's purpose for survival leads to a side effect of destroying the forest. Bushmeat serves as a primary protein for local villages, especially in poorer areas near tropical rainforests, like I mentioned earlier. So their dependence on it relies on the riddance of the growing trees. Without any viable substitutes, the ecostructure is heavily shifted without the activity of animals that roam it. Commercial logging and illegal deforestation is to blame for their disappearance. The United States Fish and Wildlife Reserve have dubbed this epidemic as empty forest syndrome, which it's a condition where forests can remain structurally intact, but are largely devoid of wildlife from all the poaching that goes on. So basically, the forest is an equivalent of a ghost town, but with no humans around, instead there's no wildlife. And this is a problem because it's the lack of biodiversity leads to an interruption of the natural ecological processes that go on in the rainforest, like pollination of flowers and seed dispersion. So without the animals there, there's no flowers that are going to bloom. Therefore, bushmeat plays a domino effect from the wildlife then to attacking the forest. Clearly, the epidemic of bushmeat sounds more critical with formal intuition. Today I've explained how bushmeat dwindles species populations, spreads zoonotic diseases, and affects our lives as well, and destroys the environment. Africa, Asia, and Latin America house some of the most beautiful creatures that the Earth has to offer. And it seems that bushmeat wants to eliminate these earthly treasures. And today, I hope that I've shed some light on this undermined topic. Thank you.
Zach, let's hear what you thought.
It was a good speech. It took a while to finally figure out what your topic was. It took almost 2 minutes, only because I have the time, I knew. And you stated a lot of facts, which was good, but there were no citations at all. I noticed that. And it seemed like you were reading from your paper quite a bit. But overall, it was good speech, just no citations, and it took a while to get started.
Oh, okay. Well, I heard a few citations. I heard like some Forest Service reference. I mean, there's statistical information that's presented, and there was an organization that was responsible for providing some of that information. I'll tell you where I didn't hear any source citations was all the stuff on the disease material, the stuff about it being related to HIV, that the exploitation of the animals or the consumption of the animals might be contributing to that in some way, or AIDS. It's one of those things where I think that's especially because that's something most people would not have heard before and would be surprising. That's a place where you need the credibility of some research to support your position. I thought the attention device was good. You had a good statistic at the beginning. I thought your purpose statement was very clear. I didn't really pick up much on the preview. In the body of the speech, the one distinct point that I heard a transition on was the movement to the disease issue. Otherwise, the first section of the material, I know what you're talking about, but I don't know what the plan is to talk about this kind of material. And when you went to the other subject, because there hadn't been much of a preview, I was going, oh, this too. You know, so I think you needed to help your structure a little bit more. The visualization, Zach didn't say anything about your visual aids. I'm surprised, you know, that's a really cute gorilla. You know, the problem is that you don't really need it for anything that you're showing us. And I think there are probably statistics, some of the information about the disease transmission and maybe patterns in which it's moving. You mentioned a country, Gambia?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, I'm going, okay, I know that's in Africa someplace, so, you know, even a map about where these kinds of things are happening most frequently. Maybe there's might be some diagram that shows where the bushmeat is consumed the greatest amount, you know, that kind of thing. You know, some bar chart on the countries that it's exported to, something along those lines. A little bit more. It just didn't add much to the presentation, but I know you knew you needed something, so there it was. All right, thank you.